Let's get started with the sleeves. Well, what to do? You measure around your upper arm above the elbow, the diameters. So when you have measured it, some people need to have 2 grannies, some people need to have 3 grannies. Well, for this purpose, for this film, I will only make the 2 granny sleeve. So what we will do is we will attach the yarn and chain 1 space here, like we have done at the body piece. So only we go in rounds, attach it, and you make 1 single crochet in that same chain 1 space. Then you go down 14 single crochets. So number 1, number 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and 14. Then we have the chain 1 space. Since we go in rounds, we start in the top of the granny and then we go around. So stick your crochet through the chain 1 space and to the next one and pull your yarn up and make your single crochet. Now you make 14 single crochets up. Don't forget the first one here on the right side of your double crochet. Since you're working on the correct side of your work, on the good side of your working chain stitch is always on the right side from your double crochet or single crochet or all the crochets that you're working with when it's on the right side. So we go up like this, almost there. So last one. Now we're at the top again, so we make 1 single crochet in the chain 1 space and then 14 single crochets down. So it's number 2, number 3, number 4, number 5, number 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and number 14. Now we add the side of the granny again, and now we need to attach it to the other side. So what we will do, we'll fold it over, go into the chain 1 space here and go into the chain 1 space on the other side. So take the good side facing and pull through the yarn. So show you one more time. This is both on the wrong side. Stick your hook through the good side and then chain 1 space. Take the other one also through the good side and pull up the loop like this and make your single crochet. Now 14 single crochets up, and this is the same when you have 3 grannies around your arm, or 4 or 5, it does not matter, like this. And we end up in the top of this grannies, of the grannies, not in the side but in the top, almost there. Voila. And one more here. And a slip stitch into the first single crochet you made. Now, chain up 3 plus 1 is 4 and turn. In this same spot here, you make your next double crochet. That means that you have made your V-shaped stitch. It's a double crochet, chain 1 and a double crochet. Now, you go down the row. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 4 double crochets together. So it's the first unfinished and the second unfinished. Is skip 5 stitches, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, into the next and into the stitch after and pull through. Now we go up again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, number 9, and number 10. So you're working from inside of the sleeve. Here in chain one, in the single crochet in the chain one space, you make your V-shaped stitch, and then you go back again. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Then you make your 4 double crochets together. So it's the first and the second unfinished. You skip those 5 stitches, go into the next, and in the next you make unfinished and pull through. Then 10 double crochets up. So it's exactly the same as you have done on the body piece, but now you go all the way around. That's the only difference. So only increasing, decreasing in the valleys and not in the tops. It's not necessary. If you have more stitches than you're counting, just skip them in the valley. It's not to worry. You won't see it. Now we're up here, and you slip stitch into the third chain from your 4, and you will slip stitch into the chain 1 space. Chain 4, turn, make your double crochet in the chain space as well. And then you go back here. So it's actually exactly the same as you have done on the body. So 10 down the row. Since this is a chain 3 and turn, it's a little bit harsh to put your hook through. Just take your time and you can make it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and number 10. Now we make 2 double crochets together. So we're in the valley. You see here the 4 double crochets together, this stitch and this stitch. So 1 before the 4 double crochets together and 1 after the 4 double crochets together and pull through. And then 10 up the hill. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 9 and number 10. Now we're at the chain 1 space again. There you make your V-shaped stitch, a double crochet, chain 1 and a double crochet. And then we go back here. 10 double crochets in a row. 1 double crochet. That's number 2. Number 3. Number 4. Number 5. 6. 7, 8, 9, and number 10. Now we're at the valley again. First unfinished double crochet, skip a stitch into the next unfinished double crochet and pull through. 10 up the hill, and then we're back at the beginning of this round. Number 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and number 10. Now you will find your third chain here, that's there, and slip stitch into it, and then slip stitch into the chain 1 space, and you make your 4 double crochets again if you need it. I leave it like this. So This last row you will be repeating as long as necessary. Normally it's two or three rows, then you should have enough. This granny should line up with the granny on your body piece. If it's not, it's not to worry. It's your body, so you have to measure it around your own body. Well, let's get started with filling up one corner here. One V-shaped stitch between first and second point of the granny. This will be filled up. That will also become the head of the shoulder. Then we crochet half double crochets around it. So let's get started. Chain up one and turn. Always turn because you need to work on the wrong side of your work. Three double crochets together. One, two, three. So start off in the chain one space and make a three double crochets together. I promise you to show you how to make the filling up like we have done underneath the body piece. So that way we will do it. That's number two. And there's number three. And pull through. Chain one, skip a stitch in the next. Chain one, skip a stitch in the next. Double crochet. Chain one, skip a stitch in the next. One double crochet. Chain one, skip a stitch in the next one double crochet. Then four, two double crochets together. That's the first and the second. So we have one, two, three, four holes. You start off with a double crochet, three together, included the chain one space and the first two double crochets together. Chain one, skip a stitch, double crochet in the next. Chain one, skip a stitch, double crochet in the next. Chain one, skip a stitch, double crochet in the next. Chain one, skip a stitch, double crochet in the next. Then two double crochets together with skip stitch in between. One double crochet after it. Chain one, skip a stitch in the next. One double crochet. Chain one, skip one stitch in the next. One double crochet. Chain one, skip a stitch in the next. One double crochet. Chain one, skip a stitch, and in the last three stitches you will make a three double crochet together. It's included the chain one space, so the last two double crochets included the chain one space, and pull through, chain one and turn. Now you make three double crochets together over the first, you're unfinished, in the chain one, one unfinished, and on top of the double crochet one unfinished, pull through, then make double crochets. One in the chain one space, one on the double, one in the chain one space, one on the double, one in the chain one space, and then we are at the valley again. First and the last double crochet together, so you skip one stitch in between. Let's first skip that one and then the second, and pull through. One double crochet in the chain one. One double crochet on top of the double crochet. One in the chain one. One in the double. One in the chain one. And then three double crochets together. So, first unfinished in a double crochet. The second in a chain one. And the third on top of the three double crochets together. And pull through. Chain one. You see it's closing up. Now, three double crochets together. First unfinished, second unfinished, and third unfinished, and pull through. Make two double crochets. One and number two. Two double crochets together, so that's the first unfinished, skip a stitch in the next, one unfinished double crochet, and pull through. Make two double crochets in a row, one and number two, and three double crochets together. First unfinished, second unfinished, and the third unfinished. And pull through, chain one, turn. Now, unfinished double crochet, the second unfinished double crochet, and the third, and the fourth, and the fifth, and the sixth, and pull through. Chain up one to secure it and make a two chain and cut the yarn. This way you have a similar way as your body piece below, as the filling ups below your body piece on top. So that way you have a little bit similar. I will advise it to do it that way. It's more even and more neater, I think. I wrote it down as you have filled up on the top of the body piece towards your shoulder seams. That way it's a pure solid way. Well, you see it's been filled up. As the same as the body piece on the, as the fill ups underneath the granny from the body piece. And if you flip it over, you'll see a little bit of a shoulder head coming up here. What we will do now is double crochet in this row. No, well, you know, you've got 10 stitches plus a chain one and a two double crochets together. So those stitches you pick up as well as that side. But here, around this edging area, you will try to make as even stitches as you in total when you make it here with these stitches up here. Should be exact amount of your armholes on the body piece. If it's not, it's not not to worry. Then you will have less stitches here than on your body piece. You will add up stitches on the top, and on the body piece you will decrease stitches on the armpit as long as necessary, up until the stitch count is even on the sleeve and even on the body piece itself. So I will show you how to make your half double crochets around the sleeve. I will start off always in the armpit. Here's my two double crochets together. There I will start. Attach my yarn and make my half double crochet into it. That's number one. I will count directly. Number two, three, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and one in a chain one space is 13. Now we're at the filling up. So every row I will see, I'll try to make two double crochets into them. So 13. That's number 14. Just find a nice spot. 15. Let's see there. 16. Number 17. 18. 19. That's number 20. 21. Then we're at the top. One in the middle. 23. 24, 25, 26, 27, I put my strand directly at the side of my work, 28, 29, 30, here I make one, 31, and then we're back at the other side of the grannies. 31, one in the chain one space. 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43. And slip stitch into the chain up one that I made to attach my yarn. Okay, 41 stitches. Now we take the body piece itself and we double crochet half double crochet around it as well, and we try to make it even as these 41 half double crochets on the sleeves. Well, when I put my sleeve aside my arm, you will see that there is a difference. Well, these stitches are even as here, only the filling ups what I've made here should be coming here. So what will I do? I try to increase on this side, here, and decrease on that side. Never do it in the top. Why? Otherwise you will get a bump here. So, first we make a half double crochet row around it, like we have done here. And then we start, when we notice that we have too many stitches here, we start decreasing here and increasing there. So that way it will be coming nice and even. It's not to worry when it's coming a bit around, because your arm is also not sticking out. So here we'll be increasing, there we'll be decreasing. If you have too many decreases, you will end up here with decreasing, not between them. So let's get started with filling up here. As the same as the body piece, we will start off in the armpits, but here we will make two double crochets together directly. So 29, I find my first row here. I haven't sewn these two parts together, so I will do it like this. This is my last row of normal double crochets from the previous row, so 29, that should be number 30. I find it easier to do it later on, to sew the ends together. 30, 31, 32, oh, sorry, you're out of the screen. 32, see here, it's my first half double crochet in the last row of the ripple from the front. 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, and 40. Well, those stitches will be have too many. That is not to worry. Let's start. 41. 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 51, so it's 10 stitches too many, 42, 43, and we're at the arms bits, 43 and slip stitch, 53, sorry. Chain up one and turn. Now we start increasing here directly, but I will make an increase on this side and on that side as well. So it's just playing with your stitches up until you have the same amount as around your arms, around the sleeves. So that's number one. That's two double crochets together, since I find it easier to make it like that. So that's number one, is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Well, I have double crochets up, made them up to the going when you go to from the granny to the front piece, there I can make a double crochet together as well. I prefer to use double crochets together instead of half double crochets together, because you will see it less that you have decreased. So in that point here, I can make two double crochets together like this, and then I go up with the half double crochets again. That way you have a nice etching. It still looks nice. You won't see it. You won't see that you have decreased on that row or on that particular spot there. So go all the way around, and then we'll go back to the next granny on the back, and there I can make another decrease as well. Well, I have double crochet around back at the attachment from the granny up to the front part. There I make my two double crochets together again. So two unfinished double crochets with a chain one in between, and pull through. And then I will go back with the half double crochets up until the last two stitches in the armpit, like this. Because there we make another two double crochets together. only no skipped stitches. And there we are. Last two stitches, make two double crochets together and pull through. Then you find your chain up one, which you made in a previous beginning to start off your new row. Well, if I will take my sleeve now, you will see it will go, it will almost be matching up with the armholes. You see? That means that you're almost there. It's best to put one row here and increase there. Yes, increase here in the armpit area, and then recount all the stitches again up until you have the same amount of stitches here as here. And then we start sewing them together. Well, I just counted my stitches. I've got 42 on the sleeve and 46 on the body on the armhole. So I'll have to make 4 more half double crochets on the sleeve. So as a chain one, I will turn my work inside out. I will start increasing here on this row. So here I make an increase, and there I make an increase. Then I have 2 stitches more, and then 1 more with an increase. So in the first stitch, I will make 2 half double crochets. And then go around up until I'm here, 1 stitch before the end, and then I'll make another 2 half double crochets into the stitch before the last stitch. So in the stitch before the last, I will make 2 half double crochets into it, 1 and number 2, yep. And in the last stitch I make 1 half double crochet, close with a chain 1, with a slip stitch, sorry, in the chain 1, which you made to bring up the height. So I've got now 44 stitches, but I need 48. So in the first stitch, I will turn around. In the first stitch, I'll make 1 half double crochet. In the next, I will make 2 half double crochets into it, 1 and 2. And then I will go around again up until I'm at the other side, on top of the 2 double crochets, in the 2 half double crochets in the 1 stitch. And there I make my other 2 half double crochets. So half double crochet round, and we'll see each other back at the end. Well, I'm back at the end. Here I make my 2 double crochets into 2 half double crochets into 1 stitch, and here's my last 1 half double crochet and slip stitch into the chain 1 that you made in the previous row. So you see what will happen. It will go like a bit around, and here it goes straight up. When you pick up your piece, your body piece, where you made your double crochet, half double crochet around your armholes, and you will line them up, this should be the same amount of stitches here. Now I already explained how to half the half double crochet 2 pieces together at the bottom. So we do it exactly the same way. Please recount your stitches if they're still the same amount, and then we will start off with sewing these 2 parts together.